A graphic of a spider silhouette inside a blue circle is displayed alongside text that reads, "What is a false widow spider?" A man wearing a shark t-shirt speaks to the camera from a path bordered by bushes. On-screen text reads, "Victor Heng."
False widow spiders are commonly confused with black widow spiders and are mistakenly thought to be as dangerous. They have a similar dark-colored globular body. The name false widows is given to species in the genus Steatota. Six of these species live permanently in the UK. The three most common false widows are the rabbit hutch spider, the cupboard spider, and the noble false widow.
Three photos appear side by side. On the left, a spider with a black upper body and amber lower body resting on orange sandstone. Text beneath reads, "Rabbit hutch spider, Steatota bipunctata." In the middle, a spider with black upper body and amber lower body with brown, wavy stripes resting on a wooden table. Text beneath reads, "Cupboard spider, Steatota grassa." On the right, a spider with a black upper body and amber lower body with black spots resting on thin, delicate web. Text beneath reads, "Noble false widow, Steatota nobilis."
Each species is fairly distinct in color and size.
Text reads, "What do they look like?" A photo of light brown spider with pale markings appears.
All species have distinct sets of markings on their abdomens. They have a narrow, white or lighter band around the front of the abdomen towards their head, and also markings that vary by species. However, all of these marks can be faded or missing, especially in adult females. Females have a globular, shiny abdomen, while male abdomens are smaller and less rounded, but more clearly marked.
An image of a male and female false widow spider next to a 20 pence piece.
Females range in size from 6.5 to 14 millimeters, and the males are between 4 and 10 millimeters.
On screen text reads, "When are they most visible?"
Every autumn, there are reports of false widows becoming uninvited house guests across the UK. And it may seem that false widows make a dash for your home as soon as things get chilly. And temperature may be a cause of this, as false widows look for warm places to get out of the cold. But many may have actually gone long unnoticed in the darkened corners of your house, where they can actually be found year-round here in the UK.
On-screen text reads, "Are they dangerous?"
There are over 650 species of spider in the UK, and only 12 are recorded as having bitten humans. So if you see a spider, the likelihood is that it's just a harmless, common British spider. Despite looking similar to the more dangerous black widows, a false widow's bite is relatively harmless. Although the bite is venomous, the venom is not particularly potent. Usually, the only symptom is pain at the site, which may radiate away from the bite. It ordinarily lasts between 1 and 12 hours, and very rarely for more than 24 hours. Often the symptoms are no worse than the pain of a wasp sting. As with any animal in the natural world, it's best to leave them to their own devices, and chances are they'll do the same for us.
A photo of a female false widow spider is overlaid on the left-hand side with a semi-opaque black rectangle on which the credits are displayed. Film, Edward Ellis Taylor. Science, Victor Heng. Research, James McNeish. Archive, Shutterstock. Music, Audio Network. On the right-hand side is the Natural History Museum logo, consisting of the words Natural History Museum, displayed in a column flanked by a large letter N on the left. Text at the bottom reads, "Copyright owned by the trustees of the Natural History Museum, London."